Hello everyone. In the previous lecture, we have already discussed that any logical function can be expressed in two standard forms. The first standard form is the standard sum of products form, which we have already discussed in the previous lecture. Today we will discuss the second standard form, which is the standard product of sums form. So in the standard product of sums form, a function is expressed as a product of sums, each term consisting of a sum of variables and the sum involving all of the variables, either in the complemented or in the uncomplemented form. And for expressing any logical function in the standard product of sums form, we use the distributive rule. A plus BC is equal to A plus B into A plus C, and we also make use of the rule that A into A complement is equal to 0. So let us now see how we can express any given logical function in the standard product of sums form. Let us understand this with the help of an example. So we have taken an example in which we are given a logical function of three variables. That is, FABC is a logical function of three variables and the value is A plus B complement into C. That is, we are given a logical function FABC is equal to A plus B complement C. We have to express the function in the standard product of sums form. So let us understand how we can express this function in the standard product of sums form. First, we will make use of the distributive law. So using the distributive law, we have FABC is equal to A plus B complement C, and from distributive law we can write this as A plus B complement into A plus C. Let this be equation number 1. Now from equation 1 we find that the first term does not contain the variable C, and similarly the second term does not contain the variable B. So we will add C into C complement, C into C complement to the first term, and we will add B into B complement to the second term, because the value of C, C complement is 0. This we know from the rules of Boolean algebra. We know that C complement is 0, and similarly B into B complement is also 0. So if we add C complement to the first term, then it will have no effect on this term. Similarly, if we add B complement to the second term, then it will have no effect on this term. So after adding C complement to the first term and B complement to the second term, the function will be A plus B complement plus C complement into A plus B complement plus C. Now again we have applied distributive law to this expression. So this can be written as A plus B complement plus C multiplied by A plus B complement plus C complement, then A plus B plus C, A plus B complement plus C. We have denoted this by 2. So this is the equation number 2. Now from this equation 2 we find that the first term and the fourth term are duplicate terms. This is also A plus B complement plus C. This is also A plus B complement plus C. So these two terms are duplicate terms. And we know from the rules of Boolean algebra that X into X is X. That is, if any term is repeated, then its value is the same as the value of that variable. So we will eliminate the duplication. And so we have FABC will be equal to A plus B complement plus C into A plus B complement plus C complement multiplied by A plus B plus C. That is, we have eliminated one of the duplicate terms. and our function comes out to be a plus b complement plus c into a plus b complement plus c complement into a plus b plus c. So in this expression we find that the individual terms are the sum of the variables. There are three terms, or we can say there are three factors in this function, and each term is a sum of the variables either in the complemented or uncomplemented form. And also we find that each of the term contains all the variables a, b and c. Now these individual terms are the sum of the variables, and we are taking the product of these variables, and also all the variables are present in each term. So this form is known as the standard product of sums form. This is the sum and we are taking the product of all the sums. And since all the terms contain all the variables, so this is the standard product of sums form. So from equation 3 we find that each of the term or each factor, they involve all the variables, that is all the three variables. And also we find that all the terms are the sum of the variables, and the function f is the product of all of these sums, and hence it is known as the standard product of sums. And when we have expressed any logical function in the standard product of sums form, then each of the factor in the equation 3 is referred to as the max term. Each term is called a max term. That is, whenever any logical function has been expressed in the standard product of sums form, then each of the individual terms is called a max term. So from this equation 3 we find that this is a max term, this is a max term, this is also a max term. So the first max term is a plus b complement plus c. Second max term is a plus b complement plus c complement, and the third max term is a plus b plus c. So this function has three max terms. In the next lecture, we will discuss the min term and the max term.